A lot of people make an easy to avoid mistake when sharpening their photography. I'm going to sharpen this image in Affinity Photo so you can see the problem. I've already processed the image, and when magnified to 100%, we can see a lot of detail. I'll now add a new live filter layer from the layer menu to sharpen it. In the Sharpen group, I can choose to apply the Unsharp Mask filter, which is probably the most popular sharpening filter. When I do that, you can see the new Unsharp Mask Live filter on top of the other layer. The way this filter works is by comparing the tonal values between pixels to identify edges. We can then use the factor slider in the dialog to increase the contrast between those pixels. This makes the edges in the image stand out further and creates a sharpening effect. Currently, the factor slider isn't having any effect on the image because the radius is set to zero. What the radius slider controls is how wide an area the factor slider is affecting. When the radius is at zero, it means the factor slider doesn't affect anything in the image. If we look at the distant hills on the horizon and set a high radius and factor, you can see them being sharpened. This effect is called a sharpening halo because what we see is an obvious bright area around the edges of objects. If we look at the area at 300%, you can see what's happening. Edges now have a dark and light area around them where the contrast adjustment is being applied. We can see this clearly because the radius slider is too wide and the factor slider is too high. Reducing both of these can help to limit the sharpening halo problem to prevent it becoming obvious in the image. Sharpening halos are something that we want to avoid and often indicate poor editing. Now let's examine the lichens on the rock. We can see that these are being sharpened, but perhaps not as much as they need to be to give them a 3D effect. But when I increase the sharpening, I begin to notice the halos again. Also, if we check the grass in the foreground, some of the lighter areas appear overly sharp. But at the same time, some of the darker grasses look fine. It's easy to draw the conclusion from this that some areas of the image need more sharpening than the others. This is true, but probably not in the way that you might be imagining. Our problem is that we're applying too much sharpening to the areas that are already quite light, and it's turning them white. That's what we saw on the horizon where it produced the halo with a dark and light edge. But when we look at the areas that appear to benefit from stronger sharpening, we see that they have a lot of midtones. So what we really need is a way to apply more sharpening to the image midtones and less to the shadows and highlights. Fortunately, there is a way to do this using the Blend Options dialog in Affinity Photo. You can use this to control which pixels in the image are affected by the adjustment based on their luminosity. In other words, how light or dark they are. To access the Blend Options, first select the layer to control in the Layers Studio panel. You can then click this small cog icon at the top right of the layers panel. What we see now are two grids. The one on the left is the source layer ranges and controls how the sharpening layer affects the layers below it. The grid is like a graph with the horizontal axis representing possible tones in the image. On the left is black and on the right is white. Then, up the side, we have a value scale running from 0 at the bottom to 100% at the top. The line that we see running along the top of the grid is used to control how the layer is affecting the image. Because the line is up at 100% value, the layer is affecting the image at 100%. Now suppose we don't want our sharpening to affect the dark tones in the image. All we need to do is drag the black point on the left of the line down to the bottom. Now the line is at 0% value for black and 100% for white. If we look at the mid value of grey in the centre of the grid, we can see that it's set to 50%. Going back to what we said earlier, we want the sharpening to be applied to the midtones, but we don't want it to be applied to the darkest and lightest tones. To do that, we move both the black and white points down to the bottom of the grid and a value of 0%. We can then click and drag the center point up to the top and a value of 100%. In fact, what we really want is for the sharpening to be applied at full strength to the entire midtone range and not just one point. To do that, we just need to add an extra point. Now we can see the line is at the top for the midtones, but at the bottom for the darkest and lightest pixels. It's then possible to apply stronger sharpening without producing exaggerated sharpening halos in the brightest and darkest areas. Now I know what you're probably thinking. I've picked a certain image to use for this video because it only works in special situations. That isn't true. This technique works when sharpening any image because it avoids the mistake that most people make, which is to over-sharpen the highlights and the shadows. But there's a lot more to using the blend options dialog than sharpening, as I demonstrate in this video. It's a great one to watch next, and don't forget to subscribe if you haven't already. Thanks for watching today, and please take a moment to share this with others. I'll see you soon for another video.